Good afternoon, all of you.
Good afternoon.
My dear Vandas, Peggy's and Maddie's, I hope nobody has changed their name, isn't it? Do you want to change? No option. No option. Whatever is chosen, it is chosen. So let us see. Maybe we were in page number 64, I think so. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Third paragraph or fourth one? Fisan, third one or fourth one? Fourth one is over. You see, I was talking about the Boggins Heights. Do you remember? Fisan, where are you, man? After the Euro Cup and the Copa America, Fisan is off now. All the glamour is gone, Fisan. Am I right? And let the next Copa come. Till that time, let us be energetic so that we will get the cup. Okay. And many more matches are also there. Okay. Okay. Be confident. One thing I want to tell you, in the next month, August, by first week, we will have one periodic test. Dates I will tell you, we will have one periodic test that will be in OMR sheet. That will be OMR sheet. We are preparing you for the SA1 OMR exams. In November, CBSE will conduct your SA1 exams, first 50% exams on OMR sheet. Okay, so before that, we need some practice. Am I right? Do you want practice? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Otherwise, we will lose the mark. Practice on OMR sheet is very important. Do you know those students who are writing entrance exams? They practice every day for 1 year or 2 years continuously. So if we don't practice two or three times, how can we write the exam? So we will give you a practice. Yes?
For the exam, should we come to school? OMR.
Exam?
Should we come to school? OMR.
Exam will be in OMR sheet. So before the S7 exam will be on OMR sheet. So we have to practice. So we will conduct the periodic test hereafter in OMR sheet. How will be there? Next week I will send you one OMR sheets PDF. Clear now? PDF I will send you. So you have to take the print and you have to practice coloring the bubbles there, ABCD bubbles. Okay. Practice how to color it. You have to write your name also on the OMR sheet. So for example, Sri Hari, first letter is S. So you will go down there A to Z letters. So first you will bubble S. Second letter is R. You will come to R. So the bubbles will be read as Srihari. On the top, you will write in capital letters. Okay. So when I send that, I will explain all those things. So you have to take the print and practice doing that. After that, I will send you OMR sheet and question paper. So you have to do. So it will give you speed. Doing an OMR sheet, we want speed. That means 30 questions, 30 minutes, 30 marks. Clear now? 60 questions, 60 minutes, 60 marks. S7 exam, 90 questions, 90 minutes, 90 marks. So let me know, do you need practice? Yes. So, Josie sir foresees the things, so I prepare you. So by S7 exam, you will be ready. No need to worry. No need to worry. Come along, come along. Walk along. So you will be given all the instructions. You will be given all the guidelines. Shania, do you have any doubt? Eh? Josie sir will prepare or not? Eh? Isn't it? Okay. Don't doubt. Don't doubt. Don't doubt. Everything will be given to you. Everything will be given to you on time. Clear now? Okay. Now let us come to... Yes? Your voice is cut. Once again?
Do we have to come to the school for attending the exam?
Do we have?
To come to the school to attend the exam.
No, that we do not know. Let the information come from CBS. That will be coming by October or something like that. But the thing is, it is confirmed that the exam will be conducted MCQ questions on OMR sheet. Clear now? That is confirmed. So we are preparing you. And once we prepare, see, once we prepare the exam very well, whether we write in our school or somewhere else, that doesn't mean any problem for us. Let anybody come, isn't it? You will be well prepared. You need not worry. My students shall not be worried about exams. Let anybody come for invigilation. Let you may go anywhere else. That does not make any difference. Clear now? So now I have told you next month, August, first week, there will be exams. Portion will be the portions taken in June, July. June 7 to July 31st will be the portion. So you can begin your revision. Clear now? 20 days before I have given you the information. You can begin your revision. Revision from June 7th onwards portions. Because March to May, we have already completed the exam. Isn't it? Previous. Now June, July. Next, we will have August, September. By that time, S7 portion will be over. Clear now? Okay. I will send you a message. Okay. So, she is coming from Boggins Heights. That means she belongs to a poor family, very poor family. So, the colony or Boggins Heights doesn't have any tarring road. It has only muddy roads. So that when the people come from Boggins Heights, their shoes will be caked with, packed with, pasted with mud. So when they come to the class, that mud and dust will be there in the classroom. And when they scuffle their sandals, when they scuffle their shoes, what will happen? The mud will be there in the classroom. So, isn't it? You might have done in the lower classes, isn't it? Karthik, isn't it? Sometimes at home also we are scuffling our sandal there while we are sitting in the class. So almost mud may not be there, but we are doing the same thing. So children thought that it is because of this reason Vanda Petronsky is sitting at the last bench. Very good mind, isn't it? Very good lady, girl. She doesn't want to make the class dirty. Chechis are not there to clean the classroom there. So she wanted to keep the classroom clean. That is why she is going back and sitting there. The time when they thought about Vanda was outside of school hours. These people think about Vanda only when the children were outside the classroom. Clear now? Why? Outside the classroom, you can mock at, you can laugh at her, you can make fun of her. Isn't it? So after outside the classroom, our Peggy and Madeline were going in search of Wanda, because Wanda very poor one. She will not speak. If you give a slap on the right cheek and left cheek, Shania. If Peggy gives a slap on the right and left cheek, poor Wanda, she will not speak anything. So, during the interval time, during the lunch time, these people are searching Wanda. Clear now? The time when they thought about Wanda was outside of school hours. At noontime, when they were coming back to school, or in the morning early before school began. Why? You see, you should know. At noontime, when they were coming back to school, what is the meaning, Karthik? At noontime, when they were coming back to school, till that time, where were they? They were not in the school. In the previous time, what we do, there is no lunch box, there is no lunch time. Lunch time is there. We go from the school home to have lunch. We walk 2 kilometers and 3 kilometers. After the period, fourth period, we go home for lunch. After the lunch, we come back. Clear now? Here, even to walk from home to the bus stop, school bus is coming just 2 houses far away. Oh, why the school bus is not stopping at my gate? I have to walk from here to there. Sometimes we think, isn't it? Water bottle is carried by your brother. School bag is carried by your mother. And how do you walk? You walk free hands. Anandu, isn't it? We walk free hands. Somebody carries for us. Still we are asking, should I walk from here to there? Josie sir walked 2.5 kilometers every day to have lunch, then return back. So, morning 2.5 kilometers to go to school, and 2.5 kilometers to have lunch. After lunch, again 2.5 kilometers. Again, after the class, again 2.5 kilometers. So, in order to study 10 kilometers a day, that is the health that I have now. Now, if the corona runs away, runs across the Arabian Sea, you people will get affected, isn't it? It need not come to your mere house. It may go around the Arabian Sea level, seashore, and you are there in Krichu, and it will affect you. That is a difference. Sometimes you people are going to doctor because, sir, I am going to get fever. Not fever. You don't have fever. I feel that I am going to get fever. Feeling that fever may come sometimes. So I may go and get some medicine. Formerly, people, when they get fever, then only they will go to the doctor. Here now, precautions are there. Why you are afraid of? Walk, walk, eat, walk. Have a healthy body. Have a healthy body. Understand? Okay. Now, when they were coming back to school, or in the morning time, when they come early to the school. This is for you. I ring the bell at 2:50 here. Are you coming? Are you ready to enter the class at 2:49? Wanda, Petronsky, Peggy, Madeline, they come to school before time. Here, Josie sir is waiting. Let the students come. Classroom is empty. I switch on. I open the Zoom classroom. Nobody is there. Then one after another entering, and these many students have to enter, and they take 12-15 minutes. Good students will be ready at 2:49, 1 minute before the class. Anjali Priya, 1 minute before the class. Anjali Priya always enters, and this first 1 minute before. As soon as I switch on here, you click entered. How beautiful it will be. How the teacher will be happy to know that, oh, I will feel that students are waiting for me. Indirectly, I will be always ready to switch on right time. Clear now? So tomorrow onwards, be on time to enter. Get ready. One click, you entered. All the students, 64, 65, or 70, single click from the different corners of the world. Ready? 1, 2, 3, click. Countdown starts SLV, isn't it? PSLV, isn't it? Like that. Countdown starts 10 BC. 10, 9, 3, 2, 1, click. All the 70 are on the stage. How beautiful. I dream, I imagine, I think. Every day I dream such a moment. I don't know when shall I be satisfied with that. When will my children come together to my class? It is a cry of a father. It is a cry of a teacher. You see, suppose you are four siblings, and all the four have gone abroad, and your parents are waiting for your return, and you four siblings planned that one day we will reach such and such a particular time to meet the parents. So the eldest one said, tomorrow I will come at 12 o'clock. After 10 minutes, second one sent the message, I will come tomorrow 12 o'clock. The third one, fourth one, how the parent will be happy. My all the four are coming to me. And when all the four cars are coming together, one after another to the gate, that parent will be so much happy. When shall I be happy like that? I don't know. I don't know when my dream will be fulfilled. Okay, I wait till my children come. Josie sir will wait. Only papa and mummy can wait, isn't it? Even you commit a mistake, papa and mummy says, my child is so good. Child is not attending the class. Mummy says, oh, she may not be all right. She may not be all right, but she's good. She's good. Clear now. Likewise, I also will say, my children are good. They might be, their car might be stuck up, maybe in traffic jam, maybe in red signal. They may come. They will come. Ashna, they will come. That is the expectation of your Josi sir. Clear? Okay. So, when groups of two or three, even more, would be talking and laughing on their way to the schoolyard, then sometimes they waited for Vanda. For what purpose? To make fun of her. Underline. They waited for Vanda to make fun of her. Let my boys please think how many times when you are in class 4 or 5, how many times you have kept your right leg and left leg to the other one and he fell down in the classroom. Just think. While they were running, you keep your left leg there in between, touching your left leg there, he fell down. Two teeth out. Remember, So here, Peggy and Maddie were waiting for Vanda in order to laugh at her, in order to make fun of her. The next day, Tuesday, today, Monday, first word, today, Monday, next day, Tuesday, Vanda was not in the school. Vanda was not there in the school. And nobody noticed her absence again. Nobody noticed. So, today, Monday, she was absent. Tomorrow, Tuesday, she was absent. But on Wednesday, Peggy and Maddie, who sat down front with other children, who were sitting in the front seats, Peggy and Maddie, who got good marks, very intelligent students are sitting on the first bench, who got very good marks, and who did not track in a whole lot of mud. Their shoes were very neat and clean, like you people. Getting from the house, room, coming to the car porch, and tells, Papa, car very close to the veranda. Car very close to the veranda, so that I shall not touch the sand. And from the veranda, your leg into the car. Clear now? And coming to school, you say, Papa, car turn and let the seat come to the step. And from the car to the first step, oh, touch soil, mud. Oh, ho, 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 ho. Maddie and Peggy were like that. They were sitting in the front seat. Two reasons. Their shoes were not caked with mud, very clean. Number two, they were the very intelligent student. They usually got very high marks. So they were sitting in front. They did not notice that Vanda was not there. On the third day also, they did not notice. But Joseph said, notice, who else are absent in my class? Fizan. If Fizan is absent for one day, I will reach your house. I have noted your house. My scooter will come there. You will have to give me a black coffee and two Parle G biscuits. If you give more than that, I will slap you. One cup of black tea and two biscuits. Otherwise, tomorrow you will say, Josie sir is coming for have a cup of tea. Isn't it? I don't want. I want all like black tea. Two Parle G biscuits, 2 rupees. Gavri, two Parle G, one cup of black tea. You can drink milk tea. You can have boost. No problem. For me, black tea. Hari Sri Hari, okay? All right. Okay. Very good. Very good. Okay. So you can wait. I will come Monday. Okay. So Peggy was the most popular girl in the school, underline. Peggy was the most popular girl in the school. She was pretty. She was beautiful. She had many pretty clothes like you. Morning first period one dress, second period another dress, after lunch third dress. Now I don't know next period what you will wear, fourth dress. Peggy had, how beautiful it is when there are different colors here. But for examination, you want uniform. Very multicolor, isn't it? Okay, very good, very good. Red, green, yellow, everything is good. Okay. So she was pretty. She had many pretty clothes and her hair was curly. No need to go to the beauty parlor to make your hair curly. Oh, because Peggy's hair is so beautiful and it is curly. Don't make your curly hair. Okay. If it is straightened, it will be straight. Don't go. Curly hair children should not go to the studio for making straight also. These film stars and all these people may make curly, straighten and all these things, isn't it? According to the film, according to the serial, isn't it? Okay. So, Maggie was her closest friend, best friend. So, Peggy and Maddie were the best friends. The reason Peggy and Maddie noticed Wanda's absence was because Wanda had made them late to school. So, Peggy and Maddie always stops her on the way and make fun of her. And she always, that is why. You see, understood? Whenever Wanda comes, Peggy and Maddie wait there on the road. And they mock at her. They laugh at her. They make fun of her. So what happens? Wanda, this is the thought of Peggy and Maddie. It is because she is not coming because she is making herself late. Wanda thinks that let Peggy and Maddie go. Then only if you are traveling, you can attend the class only. You keep the book down. Okay. So don't make your eyes spoil. Okay. Attend the class only. So voice you can hear. So it is good. While you travel, you attend the class. It is good. So voice, attend the voice. So why she was late? If she goes on time, these people would be waiting there on the road and they would laugh at her. They would laugh at her. So Wanda may be getting late so that we should go to school. And she wanted to save herself. She wanted to save herself from the bad words of comments of Peggy. They had waited and waited for Wanda. Peggy and Maddie waited to have some fun with her. And she just hadn't come. She didn't come. They often waited for Wanda Petronsky to have fun with her. Same sentence written in various forms. Clear now? Their oral comprehension question is there. So their second question, please tick. Second question. That is to write. Wanda Petronsky, most of the children in room 13 didn't have names like that. In the class, most of the children have the name Matai, Thomas, Elsa, Sabu, Lena, Alna, Mila, like that, and Andoni, Marcos, like that. This is a particular name. Wanda Petronsky, isn't it? Jorlin Jillis Jo, Wanda Petronsky, a particular attractive, strange name. Children do not have. Normal children name is Thomas, Matthew, John, Gautam, Navani, Revu, Swadi, Karthik, Andoni, isn't it like that? Common names, but she has a particular name, Wanda Petronsky. Fisan, Wanda Petronsky. Children in room number 13 didn't have names like that. They had names easy to say, easy to call. Like Thomas, Smith, Ellen, etc. There was one boy named Bounce. One's name is Bounce. Rohan Raj, are you all right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what happened to you? All right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So there was one boy named Bounce. His full name is Willie Bounce. And people thought that that was funny, but not funny in the same way that Petronsky was. So Petronsky was a silent, poor girl. So these people, if you go and call Willie Bounce a nickname or something, what Willie Bounce will do? Willie Bounce will bounce with the right hand. So these people, Peggy, my dear Peggy, Peggy was afraid of Bounce. That is why Peggy turned to Wanda. This poor Wanda will not speak against anything. Clear now. Clear now. One day I am coming. Okay. So Wanda didn't have any friends. Wanda didn't have any friends. She's poor. She came to school alone and went home alone. Underline those two lines. Wanda didn't have friends. She came to school alone and she went back to school, went back home alone. She always wore a faded blue dress that she did not hang right. That did not hang right means that did not fit right. Fit right. So Peggy and Maddie had number of dresses, but poor Wanda had only one dress. She wore the same dress every day. That also very loose, not fit. Not fit. She might have got from somebody else old dress. She did not have friends. Sorry. It was clean. It was an old dress. It was not properly fit to her, but it was clean. Underline, it was clean. But it looked as though it had never been ironed properly. You see, she had a loose dress, but the dress was clean. It was washed properly, but it was not ironed. It was not ironed. She did not have any friends. She did not have any friends. But a lot of girls talk to her because they want to make fun of her. So many students talk to her, but she did not have any friends. Sometimes they surrounded her in the schoolyard as she stood watching the little girls play hopscotch, a name of game, hopscotch on the warm, hard ground. You see, when the children were playing hopscotch game in the yard or in the ground, Wanda would go there far away and she would watch the game. She never participated in those games because those rich girls, those group of girls were playing and she was not admitted to that group. Wanda, Peggy would say in a most courteous manner, as though she were talking to Miss Mason. Miss Mason was their teacher. So Peggy would go to Wanda and would call, Miss Wanda, and seems to be very respectful call. Wanda, she would say, giving one of her friends a nudge. See, after calling, Peggy would make a nudge. Hey, hey, look at Wanda, how are you? You see, Wanda, Peggy should think about this. Wanda, she would say, giving one of her friends a nudge, a kick, a sign, a tick. Tell us, tell us, tell us. Bolo, 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 bolo. Tell us, tell us.
How many dresses did you say you had hanging up in your closet? What did you say? I forgot. Venda, yesterday, what did you say? How many dresses you were hanging in your closet, in your shelf? How many dresses?
People may think it was a very pleasant question. You see, let us come to the next sentence. Let us see who is real Peggy, isn't it? You see, 100.
What did you say? I told 100. You see, I had 100 dresses.
100.
You have 100 dresses,
exclaimed all the little girls incredulously. Incredulously means unbelievable. And the little ones would stop playing hopscotch and listen. So you see, you have to think about that situation. All the little girls were playing there hopscotch. You see, look at me. Here all the children are playing hopscotch. Peggy and Maddie were standing there. Wanda was standing and looking at all these things. Oh, very good, very good. At that time, Peggy and Maddie come to Wanda. Then calls, Wanda, good afternoon. Good afternoon, Peggy. How are you? I'm all right. Oh, I forgot to ask you. Yesterday, what did you say? How many dresses you have in the cupboard, in the almira? 100.
Then Peggy would say aloud, Hey, did you hear? Our Wanda has 100 dresses.
Wow! Hearing this, all the children stop their hopscotch and all will come and stand around Wanda. In the midst of them, Peggy would laugh at her, make fun of her. Clear now? This is the technique. Clear now? You see? Yeah, 100. All lined up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 99 hangers. One is on my body. 100 dresses, said Wanda. Then her thin lips drew together in silence. What are they like? All silk? All Kanchipuram pattu? All Mysore silk? All silk? All silk, I bet, said Peggy. Yeah, all silk. All colors, red, green, maroon, yellow, white, all the colors are there. 100 colors, 100 dress, 100 silk dress, all are lined up in my cupboard. One is from Italy, 2 are from Dubai, 5 are from Qatar, 10 are from Algeria, 10 are from Australia, 10 are from Canada, 10 are from Brazil, 10 are from Argentina. From all the countries, all the colors, all silk dresses lined up. Velvet too? Yeah, velvet too. 100 dresses, Wanda would repeat stolidly, boldly. Stolidly means boldly, with courage, all lined up in my closet. Let us go to Bogin Heights and let us try to see those 100 dresses directly. So the bus is ready outside. Get into the bus. We are going to Bogin Heights. Okay, then we will continue the class. Let us see how many dresses are there. Okay, let me end the class.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Welcome.